wife originally from Memphis, right?
Yeah.
Right.
Yeah. That's where we just come from, man. Fresh off the road, man. You know what I'm saying?
So I'm going to get back into, like you said, the beginning of the story, too. What do you like about Memphis a lot, too, or whatever? That, you know,
being what I like about Memphis, man, when I first went to Memphis, I was on tour, you know. And, of course, you know, we done been on tour with Cash Money in Memphis, and we stayed messing with, you know, 3-6 Mafia. Shout out to them, you know what I'm saying? We shot the player while you're hating in Hearst Village, you know. And I just love Memphis, man. Like, we used to love they females. Mm. Like, back in the days, I had a girlfriend in Memphis, and it's ironic that I wind up going on tour, and I met my wife in Memphis, you know what I'm saying? Me and her got cool, you know what I'm saying? We was together. And shit, man, it just was like love at first sight, you know what I'm saying? She rocking with me, you know, on my lowest, at my lowest moments, you know what I'm saying? When I was on the heroin cocaine, you know, and she never judged me, man, you feel me? And I actually wanted to stop doing drugs because of her, you feel me? And me, that's like the best thing that I ever, you know, got out of Memphis was my family, you feel me? My wife and my kids, you know what I'm saying? That's what I really love about it. But there's a lot of talent out there. I remember I was on the road on tour, and I had got Yo Gotti, Mac E, I think Criminal Man, LeChat, Gangsta Black, all us. Like, I had a vision way back then. It was before they were blowed up. I was doing songs with all of them. You know what I'm saying? Don Tripp, you know, Pistol, God bless his soul, you know what I'm saying? Like, all he do, like, me and Gotti got a song called Throw Your Sets Up back in the days. I was doing music with all these guys in Memphis. And me and a dude who wound up being, you know, the snitch on my case who sent me to prison, you feel me? We was putting a tour together where we was trying to bring all them on tour. It never happened, you know what I'm saying, because of the situation. But that was the vision that I had way back in the days, bro. You know,
so you,
I was trying to bring
Memphis.
I was trying to bring them, you know, because Memphis kind of reminded me of New Orleans.
And that's where I was going with it, Terry. Yeah, so I'm glad. And I want to say that. The reason, why, first of all, I want to say this, too, because I remember my brother-in-law from Memphis. He's from Orange Mound. He was telling me something. I don't know how true this is, but this is what he said. Somebody told me that when y'all did the Player White Hating video, that was a project of, I don't know, Bloods or something like that, and they didn't really like all the different kind of rags or something. Vice Love. That's what it was, Vice Love. Yeah. He said, and the dudes were like, hold up, man, who these dudes is with all these different color rags on. So that is true?
When y'all I don't remember, you know, shit. You know, I was on my shit.
Right, you was on your left.
But I didn't got locked up. When I was locked up at 201, I remember. Shout out to my dog D, man, you know what I'm saying? And he was like, man, I was the little dude that was such, such, such. And he was Vice Lord, I believe. You know what I'm saying? And that's how I remember, okay, they had them Vice Lords in Hearst Village.
In that project. All right, so back to that. You were saying about the similarities. People always tell me New Orleans and Miami. I always say New Orleans and Memphis, the reason why.
And Florida.
Florida, too. But the reason why I say Memphis the most, because Bill Street Bourbon, blues, jazz. They known for their food.
Murder.
Kill.
Yeah.
It's a lot of poverty. It's a
you know what? That's city. What attracted me to Memphis. Like, I used to go in South Memphis, in the Kansas Court apartment. You know, I'm not gonna really speak on it a lot, but I had met some guys out there, and you know, they had what I like. You feel me? At the time, you know what I'm saying? And I used to be out there, man, thugging with them. You know what I'm saying? They was the folks. You feel me? But I didn't know nothing about no gangs or none of that, you feel me? Because we ain't affiliated, you know what I'm saying? But them dudes treated me with respect. They was fans, you know what I'm saying? And it was like, I wasn't really just trying, like, I was on a run at the time when I wound up going to Memphis, you know what I'm saying? And when I went out, I was like, damn, this shit just like New Orleans. I started doing the same shit that I was doing in New Orleans in Memphis for the 2 months that I was out there,
right?
You know what I'm saying? And the music scene was crazy, bro. Like, you know, to me, honestly, I feel like Atlanta, where I'm at now, I feel like Memphis influenced Atlanta.
Yeah, yeah.
New Orleans influenced Atlanta, and Atlanta made their own sauce.
Yeah, you get the crunk music, you don't get crunk music. I mean, you don't get trap music without crunk music from everything that was going on in Memphis with Squeaky and Paul and all them. And like I said, it's just like I said, the murder is the fucking you know, they on the river by the Mississippi River. We is too. They 65% African American. We like 61%. Miami is more of a Spanish community. It's mixed. It's mixed, but it's a lot more like Cubans.
But it's certain areas, like, you know what I'm saying, Opa-locka
and Carroll City and stuff like that.
Like they inner city remind you of New Orleans.
Now I know Miami got a lot of Haitians, but I tell people a lot of Haitians went to Miami during the 60s, during Papa Doc regime. A lot of the Haitians was coming to New Orleans way before that, after the Haitian Revolution.
Shout out to my dog Magazo too, man. Yeah, free Magazo.